In Minecraft, a city can add so much to your world. It can add immersion or a landmark along a long and windy road. It can add life to an otherwise dull and desolate world. So let's get it right.
Step number one is to find where you want to build your city. The location is very important for this, but before you do that, you also need to figure out what style you're wanting to build. For example, if you're wanting to build a snowy village, then you probably don't want to build that in the desert. So it's important to know your style first, and then once you know that, then you can decide and find your location. So if we want a desert, we can find a desert. If we want a desert village, we can find a desert biome. If we want a foresty city, then we can find maybe a jungle or a forest biome. So it really depends on what style you're wanting to do. For me, I am thinking of doing I'm thinking for a plains biome. So just kind of a traditional flat area. And I like the color of the grass in plains biome for what I'm looking for. So just to kind of keep it simple, I'm going to look around for a plains biome. And there's many ways you can do this. You can simply just get in a world like I am and fly around. Usually plains biomes are pretty easy to find. But you also have the option of going online and searching for some seeds with the specific requirements and biomes that you're looking for. And that can be a pretty good way to do it too. So there's multiple different ways you can do it. But just kind of pick your method, and once you find a good location, go ahead and settle down there.
Here, I think we finally settle on a perfect spot. It is up on a hill, and it has a village off to the side, which in the future could be redone to match whatever style we decide to go with. It works perfectly. It's a plains biome like I was hoping, and so it was perfect for everything I was hoping for. So I went ahead and settled down here and got to work. So the first thing I usually do is I start by kind of filling in and smoothing out some of the landscape. So you can see I am filling in some holes and some of the little ponds that appear. Then I come over here to start with the wall. I add in some gates and get to clearly marking out the wall with this dark gray. It's really useful to use some colors that will stand out pretty well. So for the wall, I went ahead with this dark gray, as it also kind of represents the stone that will be in the wall. And here you can see I'm taking some time to kind of rework that little area there with another gate. It's always good to mess around and edit whatever you do. Don't feel restricted to keep what you have or limit yourself to anything. If there's something you don't like or you're not completely happy with, change it. There's no need to keep it if you're not happy or inspired by it. Down in this section, I decided I want to have a little bay area, so I dug a little bit of the layers out and then filled it in with a light blue to mark it. And as you can see, now I am putting in the roads with a clear red block that will be easy to find and stand out here later on once we get other colors in here. And it's good to just kind of wrap it around, wind it around, think of points of interest, where people will, you know, commonly want to travel, and what, you know, the easiest way of travel will be, and those ways will be the most worn down paths. For the buildings, I used blue concrete to mark out and make some interesting shapes. With this, I tried not to make many square shapes, and instead made lots of diagonal and odd shaped buildings with different angles, as it brings more interest later on. And I also, every now and then, decided to use some different blocks within the blue, just to remind myself of some of the ideas that I had while I was laying this out. So there was a stable there by one of the gates, and I used some logs to mark out some of my ideas that I had, and it just helps remember them later on. Over here in what I'm going to be calling the back portion of the city, I decided to add a graveyard and a church. It is important to add some of these larger city-type builds into your city. This varies it up, and it helps bring out the idea of different people classes within the town, with richer and poorer people. Next, as you can see, I took some time and just filled in these walls. I did it really simply with just cobblestone. Of course, it's not just going to be cobblestone, but to just get it laid out at the start, that is a perfectly acceptable way to just go ahead and just do it simply with one block, and then later you can go in and add the detail and decorations and things like that. But yeah, so one of the next steps here will be to just kind of lay out the roads and actually fill them in with whatever material we go with. I'm kind of thinking probably gravel, maybe some cobblestone, maybe some stone mixed in, and andesite. But primarily gravel is what I'm thinking. And it's pretty important for these main roads to be pretty wide. And also, these elevation changes are great. They are key to making this this place feel alive and busy. Something I like to do with a lot of my builds is I like to try to make it so that while you're exploring it, you can get lost in it. That just can be really immersive if you just get lost in a build and you don't know where you're going when there's so much to explore. So that's going to be one of my goals moving forward with this. Another one of the next steps here is I'm going to dig all this out and fill it in with water. I'm not sure how deep it's gonna go, but if we want it to be any sort of realistic looking port, it's gonna have to be deep enough for ships to get in and out. So I'll work on that, and along with that, I'll also have to do some terraforming here just to update some of these cliffs. They're not the worst, but they also just kind of look like typical Minecraft terrain generation, which we're not going for here. We're trying to make an epic city. So yeah, but anyway, I think that's going to do it for this first episode here of the city building. Just, we kind of got some of the layout done and built up some of the walls, and I'm really excited for this project. I think it's going to turn out great. So go ahead and comment, like, subscribe, do all of the above. I really appreciate the support. Share this video if you enjoy it and you think someone else will like it. That is very, very appreciated. But anyway, yeah, that's going to do it for this. I'll see you guys in the next episode here.